Good morning to all of you. I am J.B. Singh. I am going to present the lecture of power system, that is electrical power system 1, according to the Mumbai University syllabus. I am assistant professor in electrical department, and this power system is the subject which is in third semester electrical engineering department. So I'm going to represent this lecture based on basics of element of power system or electrical power system 1. So this entire syllabus is classified in 6 modules. So out of 6, 1, that is a basic part in which we have to know about the structure of power system, different type of components which we are using for this power system structure, and one line diagram in which we are representing entire power system. Because we know power system we are having for a three phase as well as for a single phase. So each and every components which either is used for a single phase or a three phase, every components are having their specific values, their specific design, their specific construction. So if you want to plot the entire thing in a paper, or if you want to make a design for an entire power system, that is very, very tough. So what we are doing basically, whatever the components are there in a entire power system plant, from generation to transmission to distribution, so we are plotting in a single line diagram, and that is also called one line diagram. In this diagram, basically what we are doing, we are representing a symbol for any specific units. Like if you want to tell about generators, we are having a specific value of generator, like a specific representation of transformer, a specific representation of transmission line, a special representation of bus bars, like a special representation of you can say that loops. It may be a different type of loops are connected. So entire things we are going to discuss in this module. So now I'm moving for this lecture, that is a structure of power system. So whatever the contents I am going to cover on this module, so this is first, that is an introduction part I will explain. Then one line diagram, how we can construct entire power system in a one line. So it will be easy to represent the entire power system diagram, and we can analyze that how the power is transmitted from one place to another place. So what are the components we are using, we can got from a single line diagram. And whatever the components which we are using in a power system, so we have to discuss about this. We know we are talking about this power system means we are anyhow our electricity should be generated. So if we are talking about this generation, so in India basically generation is at a different voltage level, but you can say near about 6.6 kb to you can say 13.2 kb, or somewhere they are generating their voltage more than 13.2 kb also. But on average, if we are discuss about this generator, so generator generating unit, it generates near about 11 kb supply, and this is a symbol of generator. If you represent like this and G is written over there, that means this is a generator. This is a generator, and this supply we have to transmit from one place to another place. That is our task. So you can say this is a representation. So whenever you want to represent something, so there should be a specific you can say symbol should be there. Like this is a generator. In a similar way, if you want to represent a transformer, so this is a symbol of transformer. Somewhere if you will get this type of transformer, so you can say this is a transformer is connected. If a simple line is connected, so this is called transmission line. This is called transmission line. This was transformer. In a similar way, if you want to say that about loads in the form of either motors or somewhere else, so it is a representation of generator and motor. Both are same, always both are same, only the connections are different. If we are using some connections in this generator, if we change the generator connection, so mostly it will behave like a motor. Some internal construction is also different in case of generator and motors, but the symbol of generator and motor both are same. If with this symbol, if we are putting M, that means it is a symbol of motor, and if we are putting G, so you can say that this is a symbol of generator. So whenever entire things is connected in a series, so you can say that this entire connection is one line diagram. Okay, so the things which is there, I am going to represent and I will discuss one by one in detail. So I'm moving for a next slide. Now, if we are talking about introduction in a power system, so what we are talking about in this introduction, so this is a task that if we are generating any power in a one place, suppose this 11 kV generation is there, but our task is that this supply should be transmitted from generating to the your domestic places. This is your domestic places. Where load are connected, so here households loads are connected. So household loads are connected. So how you can transmit this power from one place to another place, because everywhere generation is not possible. So suppose generation is one place. Suppose it is a MP, Madhya Pradesh, and you want to transmit this power on suppose in Kerala, for example. This is a place. So means this distance between of this place to this place is near about 1500 kilometer or near about 2000 kilometer. So if this distance is there and you want to transmit your power from one place to another place, so this transmission line, how you will transmit? So for that we need a one particular path. So for this particular path, we are dividing this entire path in a two manners. First, we are talking about, we are using this transmission line where a high voltage is transmitted. High voltage transmission will occur. Now, then after we have to transmit the power in the same manner, but it is called a distribution because the voltage level is low as compared to the transmission line. So this is called in second path, you can see this is a distribution. Distribution means you can say that entire things is happening in a three group. First, generation should be there. Then, whatever generation is there, we have to transmit that power, and after that, we have to distribute that. So, you can say how you can classify transmission and distribution. So, you can classify in the terms when transmission is having high voltage, and as compared to the transmission, this voltage level of distribution is low. So this is a basic difference. Why we need this transmission and distribution? First question. And second question, can we transmit our power at 11 kV? This is second question. And third question, if we are not able to transmit our power at 11 kV, so what we will do? What we will do? So the answer of all the three questions, I will explain in next slide. So read the things first. Transmission system supply bulk power and distribution system transfer electric power at ultimate consumers. So means we are just talking about transmission and distribution, means high voltage and low voltage, because this distribution is directly connected to the loads, directly connected to the loads, that is a household loads. I already explained. Now the generation of electric energy is nothing but the conversion of energy one form to the another form. So you know the concept of energy, that energy neither can be generated nor can be destroyed. Energy just can transfer from one form of energy to another form of energy. Like you know the example of suppose you are having one ball which is put in the roof of your home. That means in that position, your ball is having the potential energy. And whenever you just drop the ball towards the earth, towards the ground, so it increases the velocity. And you can say whenever height is reducing, your potential energy is going to reduce. But in the same manner, your speed is going to increase. So whenever ball will gain the speed, that means it will gain kinetic energy. So what is happening basically, whenever you are having your ball on the roof, that means it is having potential energy, and whenever it moves towards the ground, it is gaining the kinetic energy. So what is happening in this case, potential energy is converting in the kinetic energy. So this is the concept of energy, that energy neither can be created nor can be destroyed, just can transfer from one form to another form. Now, if we are talking about electrical energy, so electrical energy generated in many manners you can generate. So like hydropower plant, thermal power plant, nuclear power plant. So a lot of plants are there. By the use of these plants, you can generate the electricity. Got it, everyone? So many plants are there. By the use of these plants, you can generate the electricity. Now, if we are talking about generation, so I already explained that different voltage levels are there, 6.6 kV, 10.5 kV, 11 kV, 13.8 kV, 15.7 kV. So these are the units of generation of voltage. And these generation are basically with a non-renewable. So you are having two type of generation over there. One is a renewable and one is a non-renewable resources. So nowadays we are focusing on only renewable energy resources, that is like different methods are there. Okay, so like fossil fuels, wind plants, solar energy, so a lot of methods are there that we are using for generation. So these all things I will discuss in detail. Okay, so these things which we have to know about the introduction of this power system. Now this is called structure of power system. This is called structure of power system. So in structure of power system, a lot of things are visual over there. So what is happening? First, we have to know at the starting point. At the starting point, we are having the generator first. So why we are using generator? Generator in generator is basically generating the voltage. So in any of the forms, so mostly electricity generation in the form of sinusoidal waveform. So we are generating over there. So this generation may be by different methods and they can connect together on a single point. Their generation may be by the hydropower plants, maybe by the diesel power plant, maybe by the wind power plant, maybe by the thermal power plant. So a lot of methods are there to generation. So you can use a single method to generate or many of the methods to generate. If the voltage level is very less with the one power plant, so what we can do, we can make a grid system. And what is the purpose of using grid system? In a grid system, you can connect many more plants together at a single point, and you can collect the voltage and power for each and every plant, and we can collect at the single point and we can transmit this voltage at different level. Okay, so that's why suppose we are having one plant which is which generation is at 6.6 kV, another plant which is having 10.5 kV, another which is having 11 kV, 13.8 kV, 15.75 kV. So it just depends. So which type of plants we are using, according to that voltage level will change. So this is called generating station, where different type of generators are used, where generating voltage level are different. Now, why we cannot just transmit this 11 kV? Suppose on average in India, we are talking about on average voltage which we are generating at 11 kV. So if we want to transmit this 11 kV voltage to our domestic places, because in our domestic places, if we are having three phase, then we are required near about 440 volt. And if we are having single phase, we are required 230 volt. So our voltage level, we are required either 440, 230, but we are having 11 kV. We are having 11 kV. So what is the problem? We can just transmit this voltage and we can use a step-down transformer. But we are not transmit this power at 11 kV. We required high voltage. We required high voltage. Why high voltage is required to transmit our power? First question. So the answer of this why we are required high voltage. So the answer is that anyhow power should not be changed. Anyhow power should not be changed. So if we want to put the power as a constant, if we want power as a constant. So what is power basically? Power is, you can say, product of voltage and current, which should be constant. Which should be constant. If we are having low voltage, suppose this value voltage is low, that means current will be very high. If voltage is low, that means current will high. If current value is high, that means for flowing high current in a conductor, suppose you are having any conductor and you want to flow a high current. So what is the problem is that you need high cross-sectional area conductors. That means if current value is increased, that means cross-sectional area will increase. That means size of conductor will increase. If size of the conductor will increase, that means cost will increase. So if we want to transmit our power at a low voltage, current will high, for sustaining this current we are required, you can say, a high cross-sectional area of the conductors. That means size of the conductor will increase. So of course, if size of conductor will increase, that means cost of that entire thing will increase. This problem comes, this is a first problem. And what is the second problem which we are facing? The second problem is that whenever we are having huge conductors, so there is a problem to support to the poles, because all the conductors which are connecting, which is transmitting the power, is connected with the poles or towers. Suppose this is tower number one and this is tower number two. So if this these conductors are connected in between of two towers, so if size of this conductor is high, if size of connector will high, so this weight will increase. Weight of the conductor will increase. If weight of conductor will increase, so this chances of broken down at the midpoint of this conductor. This is the second problem. And a third problem is that suppose we are connecting this conductor, so what will happen? These will turn look like this. Conductor will hang. If conductors will hang, that means this is called sag. Actually, this is called sag. So sag will increase. Sag will increase. If sag will increase, so the chances of touching to this conductors to the ground, the chances will increase. Because conductors can touch to the ground. So earth phenomena can be occur. If suppose it is not just touching to the earth, but it these conductors will come at the lowest point. So chances of touching to the humans, tree. So many problems will occur whenever these conductors are bent over there. So these are problems are there. But major problem is that whenever we want to increase the current value, the size of the conductor will increase. So that is the main thing. So due to this, cost will increase. So anyhow, we have to reduce this current value. So how we can reduce the current value for a constant power? Anyhow, we have to increase the voltage level. So that's why we are increasing the voltage level from 11 kV to near about 230 kV, near about 230 or 220 kV, or somewhere 132 kV. So basically, how you will decide either you have to increase the voltage level up to 220 kV or 132 kV? How you will decide? So for that, we have to focus which type of transmission line we are using. Which type of transmission line we are using? So basically, we are having three type of transmission line. You know, that is a long transmission line, short transmission line, then medium transmission line. Okay, so if we are talking about long transmission line, so long transmission line is near about which distance between the one place where generation is there to the distribution, there is near about more than 240 kilometer. So that is called long transmission line. If it is near about 80 to 240 kilometers, that is medium transmission line, and we are talking about short, that is less than 80 kilometers. So it depends which type of transmission line we are having. If it is a long transmission line, so we have to increase the voltage level up to 220 kV. If it is a medium, so we can increase the voltage level up to 132 kV. So according to that, we have to increase the voltage level. Okay, now what we are using for this purpose to increase this voltage level. So basically for increasing or decreasing the voltage level, we are just using transformers. We are using transformers. So which type of transformer we are going to use to increase or decrease the voltage level? So you know very well that if you want to increase the voltage level, we need a step up transformer. So in a first case, in a case first, this transformer is called a step up transformer. This is called a step up transformer. Okay, so what is a step up transformer basically? So a step up transformer, like transformer coils are there, and if secondary number of turns, that is N2, if N2 will greater than N1, that means it is a step up transformer. Because step up means you have to increase the voltage level, and voltage level will depends on the number of turns. So you heard about the turns ratio. I hope you heard about the turns ratio in a very basic, that E2 upon E1, that is a induced voltage in a primary and secondary coils of the transformer, that is equal to V2 upon V1, that is a voltage which is a input voltage and output voltage which we are getting in a transformer. That is equal to N2 upon N1, that is a number of turns which we are having in the transformer primary and secondary. That is equal to I1 upon I2, and which is equal to K. And this K is called turns ratio. Turns ratio means you can calculate the voltage level by the use of number of turns. So if you increase or decrease the number of turns, your voltage level will increase or decrease. That means number of turns is directly proportional to the induced voltage. So if number of turns will increase, voltage level will increase. So that's why if you want to increase the voltage level, what we are doing, we are increasing the number of turns on secondary side, and if number of turns in secondary side is more as compared to primary number of turns, your voltage level will increase on a secondary side. So this construction is called a step up transformer. Okay, so this thing, whenever we are increasing the voltage level by the use of this transformer, that is called a step up transformer. So this and transmit the power from this point. So this is called primary transmission. So this is called primary transmission. Got it, everyone? Now, whenever we got the voltage near about 230 kV or 132 kV, depends on the transmission line. So again, we need to receive this this value. So for receiving this, we are using receiving stations over there. And in receiving stations, basically what we are doing, we are using another type of transformer, that is called a step down transformer. It's called a step down transformers, because directly we cannot reduce the voltage level up to 230 kV to zero. Because for that we required a huge transformers, and you know, if in three phase transformers, if you see the three phase transformer, that size is very very big. This construction of this three phase transformer is also tough, and the transportation of three phase transformer are very very difficult. So what we are doing basically, we are designing the transformer for a single phase, and we can use a three units of transformers. Means teen transformers use karte hain teen phase ke liye, alag alag ek transformer hum log banate hain. Because transportation is very very difficult, because the size is very 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 large. So if we are using this, we want to reduce the voltage level near about 230 volt directly, so it is not possible with the transformer. So what we are doing, we are using first transformer over there, and we can reduce the voltage level up to either 220 k, 33 kb or 66 kb. So this is the range of voltage which we are reducing by the use of step down transformers. So whenever you will get the voltage level up to 33 kb, so and again we can transmit the power or voltage, so you will get that secondary transmission. So means you can say, if we are talking about transmission and distribution, so transmission basically we can classify that primary transmission and secondary transmission. So in primary transmission, this voltage level up to 230 kb to 132 kb, and secondary transmission is it will reduce up to the 33 or 66 kb. So only the transmission or distribution, there is a primary transmission, secondary transmission, everything depends on the voltage level. Whatever the voltage level you are getting, according to that you can say yes, it is a primary transmission, it is a secondary transmission. Now if again we want to send this power at which we are having at 33 kV, so what we can do basically, we can use again a step down transformer, because you can say these stations are near to the your domestic places. अब जहां पर आपको लाइट चाहिए उसके आसपास जो स्टेशन है वहां पर कलेक्ट करेंगे, तो हम क्या किए वहां पर रिड्यूस्ड वोल्टेज चाहिए, बिकॉज वी नो आफ्टर दिस वी आर रिक्वायर्ड ओनली 230 kV और 230 volt और 440 volt. सो एनी हाउ वी हैव टू रिड्यूस द वोल्टेज. सो फॉर रिड्यूसिंग द वोल्टेज लेवल अगेन वी आर यूजिंग द स्टेप डाउन ट्रांसफॉर्मर, वेयर दिस वैल्यू बी रिड्यूस्ड अप टू आइदर 11 kV और 6.6 kV, डिपेंड्स ऑन द ट्रांसमिशन लाइन्स. So whatever the voltage you are getting at 11 kV or 6.6 kV, that is the voltage which we generated at the generating stations. So these entire things which we are doing just for reaching the voltage or power from near to the your users ke paas pahunchane ke liye itna process kiya jata hai, and we expend a lot for doing this process. Okay. So somewhere you are required the huge voltage, where we are required in 11 kV or 6.6 kV, you know, in your domestic places also near to the your homes you are having the transformers, and just before the transformers you are having 11 kV supply. So directly you can take a power from that primary distributions. Otherwise you can again transmit, or you can send the power. So that is called primary distribution, whenever you just send this power from one place to another place near to the your domestic places. So this is called primary distribution. When voltage distribution is classified primary distribution and secondary distribution. So primary distribution is near about voltage level is 11 kV. Okay, again whenever we transmit this send this power, and again we are using a step down transformer. So step down transformer which will reduce the voltage up to 440 volt or for three phase, and this is 230 volt for single phase. They are representing as 400 volt, but near about it is a 440 volt, because somewhere you seen that this bolt is there, yellow color bolt is there, and this symbol is make, and there is danger bolt is there where 440 volt supply is there. Okay, so this is the this thing is happening, and whenever you will get the secondary distribution, means this is directly connected to the your homes. Suppose this is your house number 1, house number 2, house number 3. Suppose this is you are having factory, or factory number 1, factory number 2, where three phase is there. So like that you can connect. So from this transformer you can directly connect to the entire loads. So this is the things which is happening, and this entire thing is called structure of transformer. Structure of transformers. I hope you enjoyed the lecture.